Of qualities such as shape, color, or form that pleases the aesthetic senses, especially the sight. But what defines our sight? Is what we see only skin deep, or should we dig deeper below the skin below our sight? Hold on tight. What if we found that beauty wasn't our shape, color, or form, but beauty was our minds? I'm sure if we stopped, we might just find that our beauty doesn't rely on the length of our hair or the size of our lips. Our beauty relies on the length of time we spent on a friend and the size of our support that never has to end. Maybe if we stopped and if we just didn't care, we would spend more time smiling and less time posing, more time living and less time coping. If we could embrace individuality rather than chasing the brutality that is the non-existent reality, maybe we would finally see that we don't need to chase beauty. For beauty is something we already possess. Not when we are told we look pretty in a dress, but when we stand up and speak our minds. We as a society had the power to decide what beauty defined, and yet we decided that beauty defined us. Now is the time for us to right our wrongs, to make beauty a place where everybody belongs. And although you may not see it now, I promise you that it is undoubtedly true that there is beauty in he, she, me, and most importantly, you.